Hey guys, this is the fourth fucking time I've recorded this. So, I'm a little... We're not doing any more side quests. Hopefully, I have the footage where I got these Onion Knight classes. If not, I followed to Papa's letters, went back to the first city, went to the first dungeon, saved those kids who were picking on Ark at the beginning of the game, and out of gratitude, they gave me what was a broken off shard from the Wind Crystal, giving us the Onion Knight job, which was the initial job in the NES version, but is the ultimate job in this version, where at level 99, it maxes all the stats out, though it doesn't do shit until like 94 or something like that. It also has its own gear. All of it is very high defense, stops all stats ailments, and everyone's sporting an ultimate weapon. Doesn't matter, really, because they all got max stats. As far as the other side quests go, I started doing them, but when it came time to get the fifth letter from Taka and the fourth letter from Sid, they would simply not give me the fucking letters. So I wasted like several recording attempts trying to get that to work. I've heard there's like, it's almost like fucking rumor because anyone really knows anything about is the DS version. Apparently, beating 1,000 monsters might unlock one of the letters. But I'm only like at half that, and I'm not doing that. To fight one enemy that's gonna take less than 30 seconds to beat, probably. It's an Iron Giant with a lot of health. You see an Iron Giant every Final Fantasy game. Who gives a fuck anymore? Let's just ram through and beat this piece of shit. It's not a piece of shit, but man, it really sucked all the goddamn fun out of it. Doing this over and over again. Now I really just want to finish it. We're just gonna run train on everything with these Onion Knights. Everyone be strong. Okay, I'm gonna get back in a better mood. Sorry. Alright, let's do this, guys. Who needs the items when we literally have the best equipment in the game and the best class in the game maxed out? I do like the music in this area. Oh man, it's so hard to repeat shit you've already said like 3 or 4 times. Oh boy. I thought I'd be done early tonight recording this. Now I'm up late. So what's gonna happen is we're going to get to the top. And you know, why am I telling you? I'll just show you. Thing is, we still needed 80% treasure, and we have 76 coming in here. I don't think we would have made the 4%, even if we did everything up to the point of no return and walked back. Which means we'd have to scrounge around in dungeons just to find enough chest to break 80. It's not worth it. And then we'd have to get at least one of the cards from maxing out a job by talking to the legendary smith. And the smith just randomly appears in cities, so we'd have to spend time going randomly between two cities until we happened to find one. Assuming I like completely understood where she would show up in those circumstances, which I'm sure, knowing my luck, I wouldn't. I gotta say, it's amazing how terrible the guide for this was. I'd be embarrassed if I was the person that read it. They just gave up halfway through and it made it a living hell. Because they couldn't they should have just stopped. If they had just stopped, I could have figured it out better. But instead, they gave me a lot of misinformation. And this is a bad first video to run into. Then again, why are you watching this if it's the first video? It's the finale to the third in a series. It's okay, guys. Final Fantasy IV is next. That one's simple. I played that one enough times, there's no way. Alright, here we go. Time for the finale. This is such a silly, like, ploy. This is not something that a final antagonist does, you know? It seems like a minor antagonist, like, plan. Do not fear. Time to reassemble our friends. We did a quest where we fixed Sarah's mother's pendant. But I don't know if that's gonna show up anywhere because I don't know. We should have been fighting something in Sid's basement. But that letter never showed up to do it, so. Yes, you're alive. Who are you again? King Alice? And of course, the best characters. Old warriors of love. I don't even know what to call these guys. Four old dudes. Thank you. We got this. Gotta get over onion swag. Finally, we get to see this person that we're sort of been going against this whole game. Sort of. By proxy. The darkness draws ever so close and is almost upon this world. Ha ha ha, die. All right. Blizzard. Nothing. Just flat out does nothing. This is why I opted for the shields instead, just so they'd just be completely, like, unharmable. Problem with this, you can't really determine party order. That'll do him in. Not even close, punk. This was your plan all along? Alright, this is supposed to be an unwinnable boss fight. And it is. I mean, it literally only has to have do one attack to end the fight, so. And yes, this is the first kind of switcheroo, final boss, kind of comes out of nowhere kind of thing. Though, I don't really think Cloud of Darkness comes from nowhere. You kind of give this with the whole cloud of light and the fight, literally the light trying to kill people before and all that kind of stuff. How you're kind of the inverse of it. So, this tentacle's physical. Works. That's good damage. But if it uses its attack, I mean, yeah. Damn. Party's been defeated. Oops. Sorry, just a second. No. you go before I do. You ever see an onion bloom? We've got work to do. Do it. All right. Start at the upper left here. Trap. Zandy's clone. More like dead. The best you got? Need a ribbon when every single piece of your gear stops all status effects. You got. Let's see what these final bosses look like. Give you an idea. Oh, they don't even tell you. You think he's a badass because he gets triple attacks? You know what? I have come to join you. Let's vary our team up a bit. Give ourselves an extra. Give ourselves some onion, another onion sword. Just because it looks cooler. Thinking about it, they don't need that. They need useful. Well, actually, it doesn't hurt for them to get employed. There, now we got some variety. Spice of life. Is there anything that this does? No? Alright, one down. Cerebus has been defeated. I thought Luna was blue, not purple. I think they screwed it up in Dissidia for the alternate costume. How? How do you screw that up? Now we're going to the upper right. Oh, there's one of these in each of them, isn't there? Screwing around. Wait, are we coming this way? Shit. No, I am screwing around. Okay. I totally went, oh man, it's embarrassing. Let's try this again. Fire crystal. A two-headed dragon? Who would have thought of such a thing? He's dead. No? Now this meteor might do it. Look at all those sixes. Chofang. Does this heal me afterwards? Yeah, it does. It does fully heal me. Them crystals sure are nice. Excuse me. This is the order in terms of difficulty, if you're just playing normally. Yeah, which one of these is it? Wait a minute, it just wouldn't let me go for some reason. That was definitely the right one. It's a trap! Okay, how do I get to this guy? Oh, this is confusing. Oh, wait, that was right. Okay. It just confused me. Yeah, physical attacks are just kind of straight out better than magic in this game, at the end game, but a splash of color goes a long way, don't you think? Not to mention their last boss does have a part that's physically immune. Don't even think about it. Tornado will work on it. All that's left is the Dark Earth Crystal. Welcome to Earth. One more Zandig clone. All right, Airman, show me what you got. Let's see if we can get this going this time. There we go. He's actually pretty tanky. Six times. Look at all them sixes. All right. It is officially time to kick this cloud of darkness's ass. We are the cloud of darkness. None shall stand before the flood of darkness. With it, we will bring the void to this world, and your world of light as well. We'll be right back. Here we go. Good music. Just like... All right. Yeah. You ain't doing crap. Mm-hmm. All right. Hopefully we can take the tentacle out this turn. Yes. Show me what you got. Nothing. Nothing. You got nothing. Finish him off, Ark. Time for your last charges. This will be more than enough, I'm sure. Hell, that could probably be it. Yep. Thank you, vague platitudes. Everyone. Time to go home. Thanks, Gramps. You saved the world, you know. Of course they did. Oh no, you don't. He's just gonna sit on this for a bit. No. Well, this is Final Fantasy 3. This one took a little bit longer, didn't it, guys? And I feel like, you know, the next couple ones probably will. The games do expand pretty rapidly as you go on. I've always liked this version. Well, I've never played the original version, but this, I feel like this is a great version when it came out on the DS, and it's still good on, you know, PC, iOS, PC, whatever, you know, whatever. Still think it's a great game. And I did get a little irritated with it here at the end here, just because the side quests... It's because the side quests, they're fundamentally were wound around the DS, and... The way they changed it to have things unlock on the PC version just isn't as good. Just doesn't work really well. But that's okay. We're getting a little gallery show here. All the classes. Ha ha. kind is fabulous, isn't he? So is Goldar. Well, that's Final Fantasy III. That's the end of another one of our power fantasies. I'll see you next time in Final Fantasy IV. This is the Cozy Corner. Have a good one.